Android Studio. So before you begin, tell me how many of you know about Android or heard about Android? Quite a few people. And how many of are using Android cell phone? No one? Fine. So can anyone stand up and tell me what is Android? Common definition. What do you think Android is? Android is a chair? Is it a phone? A television? A computer? Yes, someone said it right. It's an operating system. Android is the operating system for cell phones. Okay. Before we go for Android, how many of you have read today's newspaper? There was a news about Nokia. It was headlines today. Yes, yes, you are right. Tell me. Yes, he's right. So only one person read the paper today? A clap point, everyone. Microsoft has purchased Nokia. So hereafter, there's no Nokia phones. So all we Nokia lovers, you know, have to suffer now. No, there's going to be now Microsoft phones. Okay, coming back to Android. Okay. As we all know, or just as we discussed, Android is an operating system for a cell phone. Unlike Android, we have other operating systems also. To name a few, there's an operating system called as Apple. Anyone can name any operating system for cell phones? Apart from Apple? Symbian, that's right. Symbian is big player. Apart from Symbian? Windows. You have got Windows phones also. Plus you have got BlackBerry. So these are few operating systems for cell phones. Symbian, Apple, BlackBerry, and Windows as you just now spoke. But these were just a common operating system, a simple operating system. They are in the market since years. But Android has changed the world. And we have brought us two revolutions into our lives, which has changed our lives. The first revolution was invention of personal computer. It was a big revolution. It was the revolution as big as the revolution started by Gandhiji to get independence going for India. It was a revolution in India, but the revolution of personal computers, it was worldwide. Can anyone tell me what is a personal computer? Personal computer? No one? This is the short form of personal computer. So, what is the meaning of personal computer? See, I'm not expecting a right or a wrong answer from you. It's an interactive session. So, interact with me. You know, if you give a right answer, there's no prize for you. If you give a wrong answer, there's no punishment for you. But, you know, it improves your courage also. Someone tell me, what is a personal computer? Okay, forget about personal computer. In simple English, what is a personal? Yeah, your phone, your own private thing which you only use it. So, personal computer means, since it's your own computer, right? Okay. So, before personal computer came into existence, we had something called as mainframe computers. I think most of you have much heard about it. Mainframe computers were huge computers where I couldn't buy or afford to keep it home. I used to use it only in workplace, office, college. But when personal computer was invented, it became a household thing. Even today we all use personal computers. When personal computers came into existence, everyone started using computers, all colleges, all schools, all offices, and everything was computerized. It was such a big revolution. Those days, people didn't know what is computer. People were scared of computer. And when Rajiv Gandhi was Prime Minister, he made a decision of, you know, introducing computers in government offices. and there was a strike all over. People were thinking, computers come into picture, they will do our work and we are jobless. It was such a big revolution. And today you can see, computers has changed our lives. And it is because of invention of these personal computers that we are learning this year today. Otherwise, we will be learning this year. So that was the first revolution. After that, we got a second revolution, which is nothing but your internet or internet programming. Now someone tell me quickly what is mean by internet? You have learned in your books. Yes, tell me. Yes. Network of networks. A big network formed putting all small networks together is called as internet. So after internet came into existence, life became so easy. Today, any information I get, we go to internet, Google, we get the information. Remember your school days. Remember when you were not using computers and you were asked to, you know, participate in essay competitions. What used to do? You used to go to the library, search the books for figures and facts, make a presentation and you give presentation. But today, life has become so easy. We just go to net, get information. When we were kids, when I had to wish my friends on their birthdays, we used to buy a greeting card, write a poster. What do we do today? We send an e-card to them. Those days, we used to write postcards. Now we send email. So, internet has completely put, you know, postal department out of business. So that was the second revolution, which we have already seen. Now, we are about to notice a third revolution called as Android. And this revolution is going to be much more bigger than personal computers and internet programs. Why? Why is Android's revolution going to be bigger than this? Number one, we spend more time with our phones compared to what time we spend with computers or laptops. How much time on average a person spends in front of his computer or laptop? 5 hours, 6 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. But we spend almost 24 hours with our phone. Even sleeping also, we take phone and sleep under a pillow. Right? So we are about to notice a big revolution. And Android has changed the communications to take place. It has changed the definition of phones. Now, an Android phone is not just a phone. An Android phone is a mini computer now, or much more powerful than a computer. When simple phones were there, or when we have this Windows phone, they had only basic functionality of, you know, making phone calls, sending messages, your application, and games. But Android has transformed your cell phone into computer. And that is the reason the company, the biggest cell phone manufacturing company, Nokia, is out of business today. Finished. They are sold out. It is because of Android. And as I just now said, whatever you can do on your PC, you can do on your Android cell phone. People who are using Android cell phone can give you one of the examples what we can do on cell phone, which is also possible on PC. What work we do on PC, which is also possible on Android phone? We used to use MS Word or Excel in a laptop. Now I don't need a laptop to type a letter. I can do it on my Android phone. Suppose I want to build college management software, hospital management software, airline booking software. Whatever we used to do on PCs, now we can do it on an Android phone. Next slide. Android, a threat. Yes. Android has become a big threat for big cell phone companies. See, yesterday I was saying it has become a threat, companies are scared of it. Today we are seeing companies are closing because of Android. It's a big threat for companies. But you know, when Google introduced or Google announced, it was in 2007, saying we are coming up with an operating system for a cell phone. People thought, is it the right decision? There are already big players in the market. Symbian has captured almost 30% of the market. Apple, then you had Windows. So these are big cell phone operating system players who are in the market since years together. So a new company goes into internet marketing, internet search engine. They come up and say, we are going to build an operating system for cell phones. Even if they build, can they compete with big players? People said, no, it's not possible. It is as good as, say, for example. Now, we know a company called as Infosys, Wipro, everyone heard about, right? Okay. Now, they build banking softwares. Whatever ATM machines we operate here, those softwares are built by such huge companies. Now, tomorrow, you people and me together form a software company. And we will announce if we are going to build software for ATM machines. Fine, we will build the software. But can we compete with those companies? If we start a company here in Mitsubishi and then we build a banking software for ATMs, can we compete with Infosys? Can we compete with Wipro? Yes or no? Yes? Or no? How? How can we compete with them? We can build a company of maybe 25-50 people, but Wipro has a big, base of 200-300 people, or maybe thousands of people. So how can we compete? Obviously, any wise man will say, no, you cannot compete. Even if you go and tell your father, saying that I am starting a company and want to compete with Infosys or Wipro. I said, what really? And same thing happened with Google also. When they said, we will build a software, they said, what really? It's not possible. But Android has become a threat to existing leading OS companies. And that we can see by watching the growing market share. So people said that Android operating system is a mistake. Then by Google, they cannot compete. They will go into losses. So today, in last 5 years, Android has become so powerful that companies are scared of it. And this you can see using the market share of Google. Now you can see, in February 2010, Google's market share, Android's market share, was 9%. In 4 months, it became 30%. And then, in the next 1 month, it became 33%. Now, can anyone tell me, as of now, what's the market share of Android? No one reads newspapers or technical documents here. As of today, Android's market share is 47%. Means 47% of people throughout the world are using Android cell phones. Means almost half the world is using Android cell phones. And this has happened in just last 5 years. What Symbian, Nokia, or Apple could not do in 10, 15, 20 years, Android has done it in just 5 years. So there is something which has made Android so popular, so powerful. There is something different we have done, which other phone companies did not do. That is the reason they have become so popular. So what is the difference they have done? Next slide. The two reasons why Android is so powerful and popular. Number one, Android is free. Number two, Android is open source. Before Android came into existence, no operating system for cell phone was free. Means, if I am buying a Nokia cell phone, I am paying for the hardware as well as the software. Or if I am buying the Apple phone, I am paying for the hardware as well as the operating system. But if I am buying an Android cell phone, I am only paying for the hardware, I am not paying for the software. And therefore, Android cell phones are cheaper.
Today, if you want to buy an Android cell phone, you can buy it for as low as 2,000 or 2,500 rupees. But can you buy Apple phone for 2,000 rupees? No. But Apple phone and Android phone have same features. So that's why Android has become so popular. Number two, Android is open source. What is the open source? Must have learned about Linux. It is open source. So can anyone tell me what is open source? Any idea? Any wild guess? I don't know that answer. Just give it a chance. Any wild guess? That is the first point, is it free? Open source means the software whose source code is open. Means, for example, if I download an Android operating system, I will get the source code also, and I can modify it. I can change my code. Like for example, on my cell phone, I don't like the way my messages are shown. I can change it because the source code is free. I don't like the way my keypad is displayed. I can change it because the source code is free. I don't like all the camera objects. I can change it. That's what is open source. Now, the question arises, is Google bad? We have spent 5 years or more than that to develop the software. They have employed hundreds of people to build the software, and at the end of the day, they are getting it for free and entire source code they need. What's the problem Google is making? Any guesses? Now, we together started off the company. We spent 5-6 years and we all built one nice big software. After building, we start giving for free. Suppose that will be again. Obviously, it will be called as mad, right? You have struggled so hard, 5-6 years you have put money, you have put manpower, everything, and then you give up. So is Google mad? What do you think? It's not a technical question, it's just a normal logical question of business logic. Why is Google doing this? Yes, someone tell me? Any guesses? I'm not finding why you guess. Give me a silly question, answer. No one? Okay. Let me give an example. There is an old saying, you give guns for free, people will come buying for bullets. So they give you guns. That's so that you buy bullets. Or recently one of our students cited saying, give everyone cell phone for free, they'll come buying SIM cards. It's like that. If I want to start a cell phone company, if I want to compete with guns, I will give my cell phone free for it. And it has only my SIM card mentioned. Other SIM cards are not mentioned. Same thing, they are. What Google is doing is, they are giving you the operating system for free, but they are charging you for the services. Not just that, they have made a very good, something called as win-win situation for everyone. Have you people heard about Google Market? Google Play Store? Anyone? Yes, tell me, what is it? That's right. Google Store or Google Marketplace is a place created by Google where for my Android phone,